Hi everyone!
In this tutorial, we'll talk about how to show or hide skin elements. As you might recall, a skin are elements that show fixed on top of your virtual tour, such as control buttons, floor plans, info boxes, or thumbnail lists. While for some elements it makes sense to show in every panorama, there might be other elements that you only want to show on request by your audience or automatically in certain panoramas while remaining hidden in others. Whether you want your skin element to show at all times or to show or hide according to the media, you start off by creating the element in the tab Skin. On the right-hand side in this list, you can see that by default, the created element carries an eye. This means that the element is universally visible in each and every media of your virtual tour. However, if I want a specific component to show only in some of the panoramas or media, here's what I do. I created this component of hotspots that only refer to panorama 2. So what I do is I untick the container here in the universal skin setting. You might want to change the name to be able to find it later. And I go to the panorama where I want it to show. I click on the subtab Start and look for the container. Then I merely tick that I want this component to show when entering this panorama, therefore in. If you also tick Out, the component will continue showing in whatever the subsequent media is. This mechanism allows you to have different elements in different panoramas, something that is super useful if you want to have informative text boxes for each room, for example. So the way you proceed is you place all text boxes, in my case they were images that I previously created, untick them or make them invisible in the universal skin settings, and then enter each pano to individually tick the respective skin element. Now, as I said at the beginning, you can not only show or hide skin elements in different panoramas, but you can also allow your audience to actively show or hide skin elements by clicking on a hotspot or a button. This means you can create a hotspot or a button that, according to how you set it, shows a skin element that was hidden or hides it when it was showing. Here's how. Create the hotspot or button. Click on Add Action and select Show Hide Components. Tick whether you want the hotspot to trigger showing or hiding and select the component that you want to refer to. Make sure that when selecting Show, you choose a component that was previously hidden and vice versa. You can see that a component was previously hidden when it does not have the little eye icon in the Universal Skin tab. After having selected the component that you want to show, you can also choose an effect with which the component will appear. Each effect carries its own specifications. Finally, you can tick whether you want to return to the original state. In our case, that would be returning to hiding the component after, let's say, 10 seconds. The advantage of using a button rather than a hotspot to show or hide a skin component is that your users can return to the original state by clicking on the same button that showed or hid the component in the first place. In order to allow that, just set your button as Toggle, and your users will be able to close or hide a component by clicking on the same button that made it show. As for hotspots, the action is limited to either showing or hiding a skin component. If you want to allow your users to make a previously called component disappear again, you would need to select the action Open Pop-up Window instead. This would give you the typical closing X. Thanks for watching.